Creating a good NPC is always a challenging task, especially when your code becomes larger and the behaviors you add become more complex. As a result, it can lead to increased confusion. Welcome to the Game Dev Box. I'm Arian, and I'm excited to showcase amazing assets that will assist you in creating complex AI behaviors using a lightweight and user-friendly graph system. AI Tree features a unique decorator system that allows you to create more complex graphs without losing functionality. One of the main advantages of AI Tree is the powerful perception and environment analysis systems. Let's explore how AI Tree works. To begin, we'll need to download and import it. The package includes a demo scene that provides a helpful walkthrough. Additionally, AI Tree boasts comprehensive documentation that explains everything in detail. In my scene, I've set up a Unity model with an AI animator component for animations, an animation audio event for audio settings, and a nav mesh agent for navigation. If you select your environment and mark it as static, you can bake the navigation. Now, let's create a behavior tree by adding and connecting a series of nodes. We also require a blackboard, which acts as the brain of the AI and stores key values used by the behavior tree to make decisions. Open the behavior tree and begin by designing a simple patrol behavior. Add a random position node by pressing space. The inspector will prompt you to provide a key or value for it. Access the blackboard and create a new key. You'll find various data types available. I'll choose a vector 3 and name it position. Select the random position node and assign the key we created earlier. Set the origin as self, which was established initially, and set the radius either as a key or a specific value. I've set it to 15. Next, add a move to node that uses the position key we created. Introduce a wait function that pauses execution before running again to select another position. To execute child nodes alternately, we need to include a sequencer. Each node is numbered to indicate the order of execution, always from left to right. Finally, attach a behavior runner to our AI bot and drag the behavior we created onto it. With just three nodes, our object will randomly choose a position, move towards it, wait for a few seconds, and then repeat the process. To keep things organized, right-click and select Auto Arrange for a clean layout. Let's enhance our logic by implementing a chase behavior when our enemies spot the target. Begin by creating a default sphere and naming it Target. Next, establish another transform key to store the target position. Within the behavior tree, include a detection signal as a task node. This enables the AI agent to detect signals from the perception source, an alert signal type, and the target as the look target. Now, add a move to and a wait node. We require another sequencer, which will be accompanied by a decorator to check the key value. Ensure that the target key exists before proceeding. Additionally, include a selector to switch to a patrol sequencer if the chase behavior is unsuccessful. The patrol sequencer also needs a detection signal. Also, add the AI perception blackboard to the AI bot and select the target key. Adjust the values and configure the maximum distance and viewing radius accordingly. To provide visual cues for alerts, incorporate the AI image signal, which receives the detection signal and modifies the image accordingly. For the AI to detect the player, attach the AI perception source component to either the sphere or the player. Once the AI notices the player, the target key will be updated, and the behavior tree will execute the corresponding branch for chase behavior. The environment query system enables AI characters to gather information about their surroundings. To implement this, begin by creating an EQS and attaching it to an empty game object with an EQS tester component. We can utilize the grid generator, adjusting the size and reducing the spacing between spheres. You'll notice that the spheres are distributed throughout, but when we activate the nav mesh in trace mode, they align closer to the baked nav mesh. Let's employ the overlap feature, which checks if items are overlapped by the selected geometric shape. The items refer to an area covered by an array of key points, while the test purpose determines if the test affects item weight. In this case, the items are obstacles, and the test may filter or affect both. The score settings specify operations used to calculate item weights, and we can define a range of allowed values with filters. And we can modify the shape to a sphere and adjust the radius to observe the results. Now, you can observe the appearance of green dots, indicating that our AI can only navigate where these dots are present, while the blue dots are disabled for selection. For testing purposes, let's remove the random position node and add a run EQS query node, providing the position key to the blackboard. Running this, you will see that our AI selects the green dots exclusively. It's incredibly easy to set up and provides impressive results. Another feature I'd like to incorporate is destroying the target when the AI approaches it, along with an increase in speed during the chase. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this fantastic asset, which offers numerous tutorials and comprehensive documentation. Be sure to explore all their cool features that aid you throughout the game development process. Additionally, I've noticed that this asset includes Apex tools, which allow for flexible attributes to enhance your workflow within the Unity editor. Keep an eye out for the upcoming AI tree updates, as they promise a multitude of exciting features. Thank you for watching, and see you soon!